A recent update from the CDC just expanded their list of initial symptoms for developing an infection from the novel coronavirus known as COVID-19. And although not highlighted on this list, developing bilateral red and irritated eyes in the form of a conjunctivitis has been gaining some alarming attention in a recent publication about the first confirmed case of COVID-19 that came out of Italy, suggesting that the virus could spread through the tears from the eye. So let's take a look at this case and see what's so important about it. Hello and welcome, this is Dr. Alan here from the Dr. Eye Health Show, helping you learn all about the eyes and vision. And today we're talking about a letter that was recently published on the 17th of April through the Annals of Internal Medicine, which outlined a case report of the first confirmed case of COVID-19 that came out of Italy. It reported a 65-year-old woman who traveled to Italy from Wuhan, China, who on her first day of symptoms was admitted to the hospital and was confirmed of having COVID-19. Her initial symptoms were reported as having a non-productive cough, a sore throat, inflammation of her nasal mucosal lining, as well as having bilateral conjunctivitis. If you've never heard of the term conjunctivitis before, that's a medical term for having a quote-unquote pink eye, where the outer clear coating of the eye, known as the conjunctiva, becomes inflamed. That inflammation causes the blood vessels to dilate and makes the eyes appear red, as well as leak fluid, which is responsible for the common symptoms of a watery discharge when having some form of infectious pink eye. And at about her fourth day, she started developing the more common symptoms of a fever, nausea, and vomiting. At about day three, when they noticed that her bilateral conjunctivitis was not showing signs of improvement, they decided to sample her tears and run that to see if they could find the virus in her tears. And as you might expect, yes, it came out positive. What's interesting about this case report is what they continued to find as they tested her nasal mucosal lining as well as her tears throughout her stay at the hospital. After about 15 days, her bilateral conjunctivitis did die down and her eyes returned back to normal. But after about 16 days, her mucosal lining of her nose stopped showing positive results for the virus. However, her ocular secretions continued to show positive virus up to day 21. And then they continued to test it. And although it skipped a few days, again, positive results were found at day 27 coming from the eyes. That is significant because it shows that viral replication is sustained in the conjunctiva. Now, the presence of having bilateral conjunctivitis has been a long-known possible symptom of COVID-19, but as outlined by a recent update from the American Academy of Ophthalmology, most of these reported cases show a very low percentage of people having an initial presentation of having conjunctivitis. And that's exactly why I think that the CDC hasn't included conjunctivitis in their list of initial symptoms. What is so important about the case report here is that the researchers sought to not just find, hey, is the virus showing up in the tears, but could the virus potentially cause infection to other people if somebody was to get in contact with the tears? So the researchers took the first RNA positive samples and ran them in the laboratory and found that yes, the virus did replicate in the growth medium. So what does this all mean? Well, despite this case report and many others, the existing data does still suggest that conjunctivitis is an uncommon event in a COVID-19 infection. However, conjunctivitis is in general so common, we're talking either allergic conjunctivitis from presence of allergies, a toxic conjunctivitis from a chemical spill, or even your garden variety bacterial or viral pink eye. Because it's so common, that means that your eye care provider, whether that be an optometrist or an ophthalmologist, may be one of the first practitioners to come in contact with somebody who is infected with COVID-19. For this reason, all eye care personnel are to protect their mouth, their nose, and their eyes, whether that be with goggles or a full face shield, as in this picture here, whenever they are working with somebody with a potential infection of COVID-19. Now, I am in no way, nor is the information presenting in this video, suggesting that everybody needs to start wearing eye protection all of the time. That type of information and recommendation needs to come from an organization such as the CDC. But my goal with this video was to present further information about what we know about the COVID-19 virus and what to keep in mind if you or a loved one develop a conjunctivitis and if anybody needs to consult with an eye care professional. Thankfully, many eye care clinics have been able to adopt telemedicine in order to triage emergency cases either over the computer or over somebody's smartphone, helping reduce in-person contact and overall reducing the amount of cases that need to go into the emergency room. If you have a story to share from your experience during COVID-19, if you know somebody who's had conjunctivitis related to COVID-19 or anything related to that, go ahead and leave your story below because I'd love to hear how you're doing. Otherwise, I wish you and your family great health, and I'm confident we'll get through this. Thank you.